Here we are, baby. 8-0. Loving it.
Now let's go to midfield for the game's coin toss. They're lined up and ready for the kickoff, so let's go to the field for the start of the action. Number 45. Looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. And he got all of that one. A great kick. This one is taken by Williams. The offense just about ready to call their first play of the game. Ball on their own 20. Changing things up along the defensive front. Plummer with a man in motion. With the throw.
Meets.
He hits his receiver. He was able to hit his receiver in stride, and the play goes for a first down. So they have first and 10 here. Cleveland lines up in a 4-3. On the carry. Morgan pulls him down. John, for people who love defensive struggles, this game is exactly what they're looking for. Two of the best in the league out on the field today.
These are two of the most talented defenses in the league. Not only can these guys stop you from scoring,
they can create scoring by themselves.
Yeah, you're right. I wouldn't be surprised if this game turns on a big defensive play that generates points, like an interception return or a fumble recovery, something like that. This is tough running here. Let's watch him as he gets through right here, and he breaks a tackle and keeps moving forward. I tell you, this guy's hard to bring down.
Big play there.
Walked down in the backfield. They lose a bunch on that time.
Yeah, he shot through the line almost untouched. He made a great tackle on the back.
We'll need to get the ball inside the 24 to convert for a first down. Slight change in the defensive alignment. Only one man back. Plummer sends a man in motion. Hands it off to the back. Breaks away from the tackle. Merriman comes up to make the play. Wyatt appears to have sustained an injury and will make his way to the sideline under his own power. Sixth play of this drive. 5 yards to go. Changing things up along the defensive front. The Browns come out with 3 down linemen and 7 defensive backs. Good coverage downfield. The quarterback nowhere.
Big sack.
It's never good to take a sack, but when there's nothing open downfield, you just can't throw it up there.
He gets off the long field goal try. Not a good kick right there. To the missed field goal, they're set to go on offense at the 42.
Set. Hut.
On the carry. Ekubon records the stop. Gain of about 5. Ball on their own 47.
Delta. Delta, switch one. Set.
The Broncos come out in a 4-3. Looking upfield. Brandon is there on the stop.
First down.
Found a little room and picked up a first. 3 minutes remaining in the quarter. Moore, the lone back. He tucks it away. Brandon is there for the tackle at the 35-yard line. They have to reach the 33 to convert. Only one man in the backfield. It off to the back. The back breaking free. Ferguson is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 24-yard line. Moore picks up the first down. That's the second time on this drive he's been able to move the chains. Denver lines up in a 4-3. Hand it off. Price is there on the stop. John, nothing there on that play. Looks like he might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage.
They better mix up the play call a little more, trying to free up some space in the middle. That back just didn't have any help from his line on that play.
To carry it, Wilson stops him at the 23-yard line. The linebacker brought him down to the turf. Wyatt is back in there after getting taken out with an injury earlier.
Shotgun is lined up on the right.
Gets the pass off, and he makes the grab. The 10.
Let's go. Cleveland.
Young led him perfectly that time. So they'll try to tack on the extra point. And it's up. The point after is good. They have a one touchdown lead now. Number 45 comes in to kick off. Nice fit. From the three.
It's still early in the game, but you got to think the coach wants his guys to make a statement by scoring some points in this drive.
The Browns come out on a nickel package. He gets the count. Cooper comes up to make the play. Bell takes it up the middle for a yard or two. 9 yards to go. Cleveland goes with a four-man front. They give it to the halfback. Jones is there for the tackle. Pickup of about eight. One yard to go. Cleveland lines up in a 4-3.
Oh.
And a flag is down on that play. His face mask may have been pulled. The defense gets hit with a penalty that'll give them a first down after it should have been a fourth down. First and 10. Making some changes along the defensive front. Wayne is on the right of the formation. This pass is incomplete, so the pass won't reach the receiver.
And sometimes when you're trying to throw away from the defender, you just underthrow the ball.
They're making some changes up front. The Browns line up in a 4-3. Hand it off to the back. Merriman is there for the tackle. That was the defensive end who got the tackle after a short game. Sixth play of this drive. Eight to go. Slight change in the defensive alignment. Cleveland with six defensive backs. With the pass. And it's caught. He'll feel that one tomorrow. 13-yard gain on third down. Ball right around midfield. The Browns with a four-man front. Pope is there on the stop. Bell with very little help up front. Maybe a yard or two on the play. They have to reach the 41 to convert. Cleveland comes out in their nickel package. Reach the end of the first quarter. The teams have switched sides, and we'll start the second quarter. And this is the eighth play of this drive.
Ball right around midfield.
Cleveland comes out in a 4-3. He tucks it away. Morgan is there for the tackle. And he chases him down behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
I'll tell you, he's one of the most knowledgeable defenders in the league. He knows how to play the game. And he always knows what's going on.
Poutier lines up on the left side. Steps up into the pocket. The protection broke down there.
That's just a case of an overload where the defense
beautiful
had
blitz.
Rushing and the offense had blocking.
A
Malone is ready to pump this one away. Here's the punt. And he chooses not to return this one. Inside their own 20. Denver goes with a four-man front. Hand off to the tailback. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. He couldn't reach the corner on that run.
Yeah, as a back, you need to take what the defense is going to give you. That time, they wouldn't give him an inch.
The Broncos line up in a 4-3. Gives the ball off. Price makes the tackle. 1 yard gain by the running back. Ball on their own 11. The Broncos come out in a nickel packer. He gets the catch.
Oh.
It's free.
Ooh.
The Browns recover. It's first and 10. To make the play. Moore takes it up the middle for a yard or two. And this is the fifth play of this drive. 9 yards to go. The Broncos line up in a 4-3. To carry it, Wilson gets right in there and brings him down.
He's there to make yet another outstanding defensive play.
He made a name for himself with plays like that. He's one of those guys that every defensive coordinator would love to have on his team. He's smart. He plays with good intensity, and he's a heck of a leader.
Oh, he fumbled again.
The Broncos pick up the fumble. He's lost another fumble, John.
Well, after he lost that first one, you can see that he's paying more attention to the ball. But still, he let it happen again.
They're making some changes up front. The Browns come out in a 4-3. Gets the pass off. The pass is picked off. Breaking free. The offensive line couldn't do the job, and the pressure forced him to make a bad throw into coverage.
I'll tell you, it's very important to have pressure on the quarterback. What that does is make the secondary's job a heck of a lot easier. And on that play, it led to an interception.
Hand off to the tailback. Here we go. The 40. The 30.
Can't Bailey going to try to run him down, and he does.
And they get him down inside the 5 to save the touchdown. 4 yards from the goal line now. Hands it off to the back. Keeps his feet moving.
Ferguson
is the guy who's there to bring him down. And the ball carrier was brought down by the safety. It's second and goal at the 3 yard line. Gives the ball off. Fakes the handoff. Pressure. He held on to it too long.
Bad. That was bad.
Didn't
do a good job there. Good blitz on their part.
Denver comes out with 7 in the secondary. Dropping back with the throw. And he makes the grab. And he steps out of bounds at the 3. Almost at the 2 minute mark now. When you look at the score, I'm not sure why they aren't kicking the field goal.
Oh, he didn't catch that. I shouldn't have thrown it.
Watch how they
just ran it in.
Pressure's on. It's fourth down. They just call a great play. And he puts the ball right where it needs to be.
Okay.
To pick up that first down.
Yes, that's good.
It's on its way.
The point beautiful drive.
Is good. They've now scored 14 unanswered points.
They're doing a good job executing on both the offensive and the defensive side of the ball right now. I'm thinking they're going to keep this run going.
And a great finish to that drive as they got into the end zone, and the defense is going to have its hands full trying to keep them in check.
They're really executing out there. Seems like just about every call they make works to perfection. If the defense can get them the ball back quickly here, they might be able to put this one away very early.
And we're controlling the game here. Got to keep it up.
Cleveland using three linebackers. They give it to the halfback. Merriman stops him at the 33-yard line. And they go with a no huddle.
On the play.
Going to the air on first down. Throws it. And he gets his target. Cooper is there on the stop.
You know what this does? It keeps one defense on the field. And it doesn't let them get the right personnel in there sometimes.
Steps up with the pass.
God, come on.
Diving back.
We've hit him every time.
They'll go with a hurry up offense. Closing in. The rush gets to him from behind. He's rushing the offense back to the line. Under pressure.
Oh, pick it.
Almost picked off. Poutier was the one they were trying to get the ball to.
If they're going to get the first here, they'll need their offensive line to maintain their block and give the quarterback enough time to make a good throw.
Just over a minute still to go. Changing things up along the defensive front. The Browns come out in a dime package. Drops back with the pass. He hits his receiver. Number 95 is there on the stop. Jason Elam lines up for the field goal to try to put them on the board for the first time in the game.
Oh, he won't catch it.
That one doesn't have the distance and comes up short. We're just about down to 1 minute. Shelton lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Hand off to the tailback. Brandon records the tackle. Good gain on the ground gives them what they needed for a first.
That's just good running. They sent a couple of blitzes in to try and stop him in the backfield. But he just broke free and got past the sticks for a first down.
Moore is lined up on the right. Going to the air on first down.
Oh, why would he?
Oh, bad the coverage on the play. Looking to pick up a first and moving down the field. Still a chance for them to increase their lead.
Yellow, 74.
The Broncos come out in a dime package. Rolls out to his left.
Fuck.
Good coverage scheme there, creating problems for the quarterback.
He's had a tough time making reads when the defense mixes up their zone. What you want to do is look to the middle of the field or the seam right between the corner and the safety for completion.
They'll run this one. There he goes. They'll knock him out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
Right here is how he can hurt you. They get him in a third down situation. But if they can give him a lane to run through, he's going to take it. And right there, he takes it for a big first down.
After the play, yeah, of course it does.
Throwing. Wilson brings him down. Young makes a great throw on the run.
And the receiver was right there looking for it. That's exactly what you like to see on offense. Chemistry between your players. He's one of those guys who will try and buy some extra time with his leg.
Oh, he jumped it. Oh.
Separating when he can buy him that dumb time. The defense should be looking for a pass, even if they have a few timeouts. The run doesn't seem like a smart call, because they should be trying to get him within range of a touchdown right now, which means a pass would do the trick.
Rolling out to his left. He'll take off, and he goes out at the 15. And John makes the call and does it himself.
What they have to do to stop that kind of play is get a good rush up the middle from the tackle and have the ends take an outside rush to keep them in the pocket. Well, that's what will happen.
The Broncos line up in a 4-3. With the pass, and he makes the grab.
Touchdown, Brown.
Watch his play. He's able to find a hole in the defense and he gets into the end zone. Now that's an example of how to use your personnel in the red zone and how to create mismatches.
Good drive.
Set. Hut.
The kick is up. The extra point attempt is good. They go up by 3 touchdowns after getting that one into the end zone. Number 45 is just about ready to kick this one away. Good distance. This one is handled by Williams.
Oh. Damn it.
I don't think they can do much more than just throw one long. So I'm sure the defensive coach is telling his guys, don't get beat deep.
Wayne is on the right of the formation. With the throw.
They were to an offensive lineman who caught it.
It's the end of the second quarter with the score. Just about ready for the second half as they line up for the kickoff. Booming kick downfield. From the 1 yard line.
Okay.
The Browns dictated the pace in the first half with a very solid offensive performance. First and 10. Denver comes out in a 4-3. Hand it off. Farafei with the stop. Moore couldn't find an opening and was brought down very quickly. Ball on their own 20. Denver goes with a 4-man front. Hand it off to the back. Spins away. Wilson brings him down.
Busted through for a few tough yards.
Try to trust him one more time.
Third and 5. And here's a look at each team's success on third down so far. The Broncos come out in a nickel pass.
How the fuck is he?
Drags the ball carrier down behind the line.
There's no way he's running around all those guys.
Third down run comes up short, so we should see a punt here. And rather than punt, they're going to let the offense have a shot at this fourth down.
Big play.
Throwing. Room to run. The 40. And he's pushed out of bounds. At the 45-yard line.
This is just a great play to pick up the first down and keep the drive alive. I mean, it's fourth down. You got one last shot to do it, and they do it perfectly.
Hand off to the tailback. Williams records the tackle. Moore got the carry there and is now closing in on 100 yards rushing. Second and 6 coming up here. Denver goes with a 4-man front. They give it to the halfback. Brandon stops him. What a run, netting them a first down. It's first and 10. Denver comes out in a 4-3. Hands it off to the back. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. Moore couldn't escape the pursuit and was cut down quickly. To reach the 33 to convert. The Broncos come out in a 4-3. Looking to run it here. Missed tackle. Ferguson is there for the tackle.
He's looked pretty good so far. It's going to be up to the defensive coordinator to make some adjustments and find a way to slow him down.
Ninth play of this drive. 2 yards to go. Booker is on the outside instead of in the backfield. On the carry. Fakes the handoff. Throws it. He finds his man. Williams comes up to make the play. At the 16. Picked up a lot of yardage and a first down.
You can count on him to make a handful of great catches throughout the game and really get that field spread.
And this is the 10th play of this drive. They're within striking distance here.
Set.
Denver goes with a four-man front to carry it. Right. Brings him down. Shelton battles his way forward for what appears to be a two-yard pick. The first down marker is just inside the six-yard line. Denver lines up in a 4-3. Hand it off. Ferguson makes the tackle. Top-notch tackle by the safety. The first down marker is just inside the six-yard line. Denver comes out in their nickel pack. Gets the pass off, and he makes the grab.
This is good communication between the quarterback and his receiver to keep the chains moving. They know where the first down marker is, and they recognize the type of coverage the defense is playing. The ball is there, and so is the cat.
Gets the call. Closing
oh,
in.
How's he?
Incomplete as the defender knocks it away. Tried going for the end zone on first down, but couldn't get it in there. It's second and goal at the 1 yard line. Gives the ball off. Fakes the handle. Under pressure. Touchdown, Cleveland. Great job by the quarterback to get it in.
Go.
They'll line up for the extra point. And it's on its way. The extra point attempt is good. Big time drive there, John. More than 10 plays, and it winds up with a touchdown.
Anytime you can keep the defense on the field for that many plays and keep the chains moving, you're doing something right.
All right, let's keep it rolling.
On the board, we also wear down that defense.
This one is handled by Williams. The Broncos will start this drive from the 24. Ball on their own 24. Defensive line shifting around a bit. Cleveland comes out in their nickel package. Hand it off. Pope makes the tackle. Pickup of 11 on first down. It's first and 10. John, their first down rushing average is very impressive.
Yeah, they're getting some solid blocking inside and outside. It seems like he's picking up huge chunks of yardage every time they hand him the ball.
About two to go. Poutier is lined up on the left. Pressure coming.
Another sack.
The offensive line are shaking their heads now and trying to determine how that guy's been able to get back there three times.
Third and a deuce. Wayne lines up on the right side. Pressure with the pass. Incomplete pass. Marshall was his intended target. Malone will come into this game to punt. Here's the kick. He signals for a fair catch. First and 10. The Broncos with a four-man front gives the ball off. Brandon is there for the tackle. Safety came up to make the play. Less than a yard to go. The Broncos come out in a 4-3 to carry it. This one will be spotted at the 29-yard line. chugs ahead, picked up solid yardage. Moore, the long setback. Hand off to the tailback. Ecubon is there on the stop at the 28. He tried to pick his way through the middle, but there was no room.
Yeah, he was looking for a hole or a gap, but the defensive line sealed everything up.
Handed off to the
another one.
He has room. The 40, midfield. The 40, the 30, the 20, the 10.
Let's go, baby. It's a lot of rushing yards. Hell yeah.
The kicker lines up for the point after. And it's up. The point after is good. Good job moving the ball the length of the field for the touchdown.
Scoring a touchdown not only puts points on the board, it sends a message to the other team that if you execute properly, they won't be able to stop you. And they say 90% of the game is half metal.
This one is taken by Williams. The defense did a very good job against them the last time they had possession, forcing a punt. So they have first and 10 here. Cleveland comes out in a 4-3. Looking for room. Dansby comes up to make the play.
On the run.
Bell takes advantage of a little daylight. Picks up 3 yards. So we've reached the end of the third quarter with the Browns ahead of the Broncos 35-0. It's second down and 7 to go. Cleveland using 3 linebackers. Closing in.
Almost picked off. Ooh,
nearly picked off. Morgan had his hands on it.
I think he was invisible out there. Wasn't even seen. That's a break for the offense.
Making some changes along the defensive front. Pump faking. Looking left for the long pass. The defender's got it.
Yo-ho.
Plummer has that one picked off.
The ball and the defender and the receiver all got there at the same time.
So after the interception now, it's first and 10. Only one man in the backfield. He hands it off. Gets it. Ecubon is there for the tackle. Moore takes advantage of a little daylight. Picks up 3 yards. Second and 8 coming up here. The Broncos with a 4-man front. They give it to the halfback. Great fake. Gets the pass off.
Oh, he
broken up.
Recovered.
Ferguson is getting up very slowly. It looks like he'll head toward the sideline and we'll get you an injury report as quickly as possible. Shockey lines up on the right side. Gets rid of it. And he makes the grab. Stiff arm to the ground. And he goes out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Perfect spiral on that pass.
This is a guy who can make all the throws out there. He shows a nice touch in the short patterns, can thread it in there against tight coverage, and he can put some air under when he's trying something downfield.
The back breaking free. Loses the defender. Running hard, going right through the arm tackles. First down marker is just inside the 32. The Broncos line up at a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback. Shelvin takes it up the middle for a yard or two. And this is the 6th play of this drive. About a yard to go. They've executed very well on third down so far, and that's a big reason why they're ahead at the moment. With the throw, with the adjustment, Williams
down.
Up to make the play at the 23. The Browns get the big strike again for their second long third down conversion on this drive.
Well, earlier we saw the injured player heading back to the locker room, and right now they don't know how serious it is, but his return in this game is doubtful.
Moore wasn't able to get anything going on that play. The first down marker is just inside the 13.
Set. Yellow. 16.
Hold the block, Shafi.
He was looking for room outside. There was none.
Sometimes these outside runs take a little too long to develop, giving the defense a chance to make a play for a loss.
Shafi is on the right of the formation. Throwing. And he makes the grab. It's on the ground. The offensive lineman picks it up.
Watch this hit. He gets his helmet right under his chin and wham. He takes him straight to the turf.
Green, 25. Set, cut.
Drops back. Gets the pass off. And he hits his target.
First down.
It's first and goal at the 7-yard line. The Broncos come out in a 4-3. He hands it off. Bright records the tackle. Five more yards to get it into the end zone. Number 17. He's lined up on the left. With the pass. Touchdown, Brown. Great job finding his target for a fourth quarter score.
Woo!
The lineup for the extra point. The kick is up. The point after is good. The Browns continue to increase their lead. Number 45 is back and ready to put this one in the air. He got all of that one. This one is handled by Williams. The last drive ended with an interception. So let's see what happens as they take over again. First and 10. Slight change in the defensive alignment. Poutier is on the left side of the formation. Under pressure, gets rid of it. Broken up. Williams with the coverage.
Number 88, the intended receiver on the play.
Almost at the 2-minute mark now. Cleveland goes with a 4-man front. Drops back, steps up. Pressure coming, throwing. He finds his way. We're going to spot this one at the 40.
Perfect execution to get this first down. Look at it here. He knows how far they have to move the chain. And he gets it by making the right decision and laying it in there like that.
With the pass, this pass is incomplete. Too much on that throw, sailing over the receiver's head.
Number 80, the intended receiver on the play.
2-minute warning coming up. Poutier lines up on the left side. With the throw, and it's caught. Williams brings him down.
This is what they have to do. Keep making completions down the field and move the chain. Watch this one. He knows he's got to get the first, and he picks the right guy to throw it to.
And this is the fifth play of this drive. Number 44 is on the right of the formation.
Big hit.
Down he goes. Sean Merriman has just been dominating defensively. He has 4 sacks.
It seems like every time they go back to pass, he's already back there hitting the quarterback.
Throwing. The pass is picked off. Jones with the dive. Jones had that pass land right in his lap.
You know, the defensive coordinator disguises his coverage so well that the quarterback thinks he's seeing
unbelievable.
When in reality, something else is going on. That gets the defense turnover.
Denver goes with a 4-man front. Gets the call. Goal is there on the stop. The linebacker comes up to make the tackle.
Ball on their own 36. Denver using three linebackers. Hand it off. Ekubah is there for the tackle.
I'm guessing this should be a run. The defense can't be lollygagging around, because if they are and they give up a first, this one's over.
Shockey is lined up on the right. Dropping back.
Oh, what? How?
Strange call throwing it here, John, because most of the time you'd see a run in this situation.
But that might be exactly why they're passing. You have to complete it to keep the clock moving.
Don't know why they're going for it here. You'd think they'd just punt. Gets the pass off. He finds his man. Huh. Takes him down. And they convert on fourth down. Ball on their own 46. Fifth play of this drive. Just over a minute still to go. Denver goes with a four-man front. Gives the ball off. Wright is there for the tackle.
They've done a good job moving the ball on the ground. And you can give most of the credit to that big offensive line. They've controlled the line of scrimmage from the very start.
The Broncos come out in a 4-3.
God fucking damn.
At
fucking
the 49-yard line. Moore couldn't get out of the backfield. Seventh play of this drive. Ball right around midfield. They've done very well on third down to this point. Looking to run it here. Brandon is there on the stop. And that gain will get them a fresh set of downs. Ball on the 42-yard line. The Broncos line up in a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback. Goal records the
pass
at the 39-yard line. They don't deviate at all from the last play call as they keep it on the ground. They'll come out running here to wind the clock down. The first down marker is just inside the 32. Denver comes out in their nickel pack. The carry.
What?
Fumble. The Broncos pick it up. Can't bring them down. The 30, the 20, the 10, 5. Touchdown, Broncos. He recovers the loose ball and finds his way to the end zone.
That's what we get for trying to get 200 yards rushing with one player.
Elam comes in to attempt the point after. And it's up. The point after is good. The Broncos still with a huge deficit to overcome. Malone comes in to kick off. Sends it sailing. This one is taken by Logan. They're just trying to use up as much time as they can and pick up the win. Only one man back on the ground.
Oh, come on.
Stop behind the line. Cleveland will call a timeout here. So this could be the last play of the game. The Broncos come out in a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback, running with a lot of room in front. Huck makes the play.
I don't think we got him to 200 yards on the ground for the day, but
runs out. The final score is Cleveland 42.
That's a dominating performance right there.
This is Al Michaels with John Madden saying goodbye for EA Sport.
Well, thank you for watching, and we'll be back hopefully tomorrow with some more content. We'll see you next time.